I didn't like. And they apparently like me back, because every time I'm talking to one, you guys start listening. So I'll tell you who I am later, because it's not written in this part of my program. But what we're going to do now is talk about the fact that the silent auction will close in 5 minutes. So those of you waiting for that last little slip-in opportunity, it's now. And in the meantime, as you're finishing up that, take a moment. I'd like to introduce my pastor and all-around great guy, Pastor Ken Philbeck, who will say our invocation for the evening.
Hey, will you pray with me? Father, we are so thankful for this night. It's one of those nights that I hope, I know I, and I hope everyone looks forward to every year, because you get to see a legacy being built year to year to year. A legacy from the Low Country Down Syndrome Society to the men and women who serve, to the young men and women that you have created uniquely in your image, Father, that is creating life change throughout this region. And so tonight, I just pray for those young men and women who are going to receive this award, and we're thankful for the opportunity just to honor them, to be able to bring them up and say thank you for your life and the impact that you are making on us. Thank you to the companies that look past any struggle and see value. And we pray, Father, that the legacy being created there is something that goes on for generations. That long after we're gone, this same thing is happening and lives are being changed. So, Father, tonight we thank you for the people who are differently able than we are, who serve for the sake of serving, who were created in your image, uniquely created to do exactly what they're doing and to be a blessing in our lives. We pray you'll bless this evening, our food, our fellowship. It's in your Son's name we pray. All God's people said, amen. Amen.
Jamie Dean? Jamie Dean? Have y'all seen Jamie Dean? There he is!
Well, hey, y'all! Brother. Thank you all for coming and welcome to the 2018 Night of Champions. A night that I look forward to with anticipation every year. Thank you for coming. What a beautiful space we're in this year. We're so grateful for the opportunity to be here. Tonight's theme is legacy, and Allison and I have been talking, and I've been thinking about it this week, and what legacy means, and what it means to us and to other people. And so I decided to look it up, and I was surprised that the definition of legacy is an amount of money or land left to someone in a will. All these years, I've been wrong. I would not have guessed that's what legacy meant. Let's take Bill Gates. One day he will sell or pass on the business that he started in a garage in the Pacific Northwest. The foundation that he and his wife have started several years ago, traveling the globe in a humanitarian effort to do good, seems to me more of a legacy than him and a computer. Here, more locally, let's talk about Georgia football. Half of us are thinking about it anyway. How about the Junkyard Dogs?
Yeah.
How about a big team and a little me? How about Gatta? How about Attack the Day? This is a legacy of the University of Georgia. Go Dogs.
Go Dogs.
The first word that both of my boys spelled was G-E-O-R-G-I-A. They were spelling it before they got out of the crib. That's awesome. Even our friends south down in Gainesville, they have a legacy. Mullets and gold chains and jean shorts.
Wow.
Go Dogs.
Go Dogs.
It's my parents' legacy to my brother and I. It's to tell each other and your family that you love each other every day. You hug and kiss. That family is precious. That you stick together. That you love each other. Family, that's a legacy.
Our restaurant has been around for 30 years, and we have a legacy of true gratitude to our customers. I remember the earliest customers that we had on Eisenhower or when we were on 60th Street, and I'm so grateful for those people, and it's so fun to see them and say, I remember when you'd come in with the basket and you'd have the pimento cheese sandwiches.
I was one. I used to buy sandwiches when I walked in the
door. It's a big team, little me, for us in our family business. No job is too small for the family. Yesterday I was downtown, and when a dog did his business on the sidewalk, was anyone surprised when it was me who picked up instead of passing off this duty? That's a pun.
Duty.
Maybe some people were, but most weren't. Because we work. And that's our legacy at our restaurant. We work and we have true gratitude for everyone that comes into our business. The legacy that I hope to pass on to my sons, Jack and Matthew, be positive. Be inclusive. Be slow to anger, yet quick to love. You work hard. You go with the flow. You say your prayers and you give thanks. You pray for everyone. And that the people that you meet who seem mean or rude or act in ways that we don't understand, that's the people that may need our prayers the most. You be kind. And also go dogs. I'm here tonight as part of John and Candy Bogardus' legacy. What started for me on a flatbed trailer speaking to 70 people at a buddy walk years ago has grown to this. Tonight we are all part of this legacy of celebration of the human spirit and the celebration of the different able. We all here tonight play a part in this legacy, but it's John and Candy's, and it is awesome. I'm so thankful to have been able to participate for the last 7 or 8 years at Night of Champions. It means a lot to me. And just thank you all for coming. Thank you, John and Candy. I tell your story and I share it, the strength that you had and what you were able to build from nothing. That is really the true example of a legacy. And all that being said, our kids would probably like the money too. Thank y'all.
Harvin. Wow, that was loud. And yeah, I want to kind of talk about legacy too. You know, sometimes, sorry, I'm not used to these two big giant mics. I'm just like fighting the urge to go, are you ready to rumble? I mean, but I'm going to fight it. So y'all pray for me, okay? Because like I said, I love the microphone. So, like, Jamie found his definition of legacy about the passing of property, and it surprised him. I saw that, too, and I decided to go with the second definition of legacy, where it's defined as something left by the past for the future. And how well does that speak to what we've got going on here? So, speaking of the past, leaving a legacy for the future, creating those vocational opportunities because of their hard work, because of their dedication, because of their passion. Can I have all the past champions who have ever been a champion at Night of Champions just stand up right at your seat and let us recognize you? Down syndrome and was the healthiest sharpest kid of four that we had, and died suddenly from an illness in 2012, but not before she got me involved with Night of Champions. So Emma Blue helping to write her dad and I's legacy also helped write this passion for this program that I have into my legacy. And this night has become part of hers. Thank you so much for being a part of it.
Right now, I'd like to introduce the Low Country Down Syndrome Society's president and Night of Champion co-chair, Mr. Tom Kinkle.
You guys make this look so easy. Thank you everybody for being here. And thank you Emily, my daughter, 3 years old with Down syndrome, for giving me a reason to be here and to be involved in this legacy of John and Candy, Low Country Down Syndrome Society, and Night of Champions. And if you look on your program, and just notice the logo that's here. 8 years ago was the first Night of Champions, and we recognized 5 champions in front of 200 people at the Mighty 8th Air Force Museum. And now, 8 years later, we'll recognize the 47th champion in front of roughly 800 attendees. This is really an incredible, incredible event. But I ask you to look at this logo because each of the champions over the years represents a beacon that lights the way for a brighter tomorrow. And with each subsequent year, we don't pass a torch on, but we light new torches. And so over now the ninth year, that light has become very bright and it's getting noticed. And so I'm very happy to announce that Candy Pickard, who was here last year as our featured speaker from National Down Syndrome Society, and the president of the National Down Syndrome Society, Sarah Hartwig, are here tonight with us. So thank you both for being here. Sarah Hartwig is the president and CEO of the National Down Syndrome Society. It's the largest nonprofit organization in the United States dedicated to the advocacy of people with Down syndrome and their families. NDSS, through Sarah's leadership, led the way, to the passage of the ABLE Act, the Achieving a Better Life Expectancy? Experience? I knew that. It's just the nerves. Achieving a Better Life Experience is hailed as the most significant legislation in the Different Abilities community since the ADA, the Americans with Disabilities Act. Sarah is an international expert and featured speaker on Down syndrome, advocacy, the ABLE Act, and human rights for people with disabilities. With that, Sarah.
Introduction. It is such a pleasure to be in Savannah this evening for the 9th annual Night of Champions. For all of our NDSS and Low Country Down Syndrome Society friends, Brian, Pam, I don't see your wife with you, she's somewhere, Candy, John, Tom, Joe, and Ben. For me, the third time is a charm, so thank you for inviting me for the third time. I'm glad I was able to make it. It's an honor to be the featured speaker for this evening's festivities. I know how special tonight is. I know how hard the board of the Low Country Down Syndrome Society works to make this night possible. I know how the sponsors, guests, employees, and families mean to the success of tonight. So thank you for allowing me and Candy, my dear colleague and friend who was your featured speaker last year. I have some very big shoes to fill. Mine aren't quite as big, but I heard she hit it out of the park last year. Thank you for allowing us to be here this evening to celebrate the success of this organization, but also to talk about how the Low Country community is paving the way to create a more inclusive community and workforce. The goal isn't to live forever. The goal is to create something that will. Tonight's theme has given me a chance to think about my legacy at NDSS and in the disability community. It's hard to believe that I've been part of this community for almost 2 decades. I grew up with a best friend, Casey, who has Down syndrome from Kansas. I started working with Casey almost 2 decades ago, the summer after my freshman year of college, as her support advisor. This opportunity to work with Casey quickly turned into a lifelong friendship. She opened my eyes not only to the challenges she faced, and she actually still faces at the age of 33, but the opportunities before her. How, as an advocate, coupled with proactive public policy solutions, we can shape the future for not just Casey, for generations of all people with Down syndrome. This friendship has led me to pave a career path. I was inspired to work for an organization like NDSS, and today I'm very proud and humbled to lead the world's largest Down syndrome organization. NDSS and our legacy could be defined or distinguished by a few things. Our new mission statement, which we launched last year, to be the leading human rights organization for all individuals with Down syndrome. This powerful statement shows the world we are moving past awareness and acceptance, but one that shows that all life has value and meaning, and that people with Down syndrome make this world a better place. Achieving a Better Life Experience Act, like Tom just did a beautiful job, so I won't go into great detail. But as he said, this legislation was significant, and today we have over 15,000 ABLE accounts with over $80 million in assets, $80 million that the Down syndrome community and the larger differently ABLE community can now save for the future for their loved ones with disabilities. Most significant legislation we've passed in 28 years. So this is my shameless plug. This is a disability community event. You should all go on and open up your ABLE accounts for your loved ones with disabilities. It will add tremendous value to the life. And one of the things that I said to Brian and Tom and Joe and so many others, what makes this community unique is your focus on creating a more inclusive workforce in your community. Like the Low Country Down Syndrome Society, NDSS has the only national employment program called DS Works, or it's 2018, so it's actually hashtag DS Works, which is focused on showing the world that people with Down syndrome are ready, willing, and able to work. Financial, the NHL, the NBA, and small businesses like Blake's Snow Shack and John's Crazy Socks, the Capital Candy Jar, which are showing everyone from Main Street to Wall Street and everywhere in between what people with Down syndrome and other disabilities truly bring to the workplace. And at NDSS, and just like LDSS, we're focused not just on creating job opportunities, we're focused on creating careers for people with disabilities. And I could talk about our End Law Syndrome campaign, but I'm gonna get back to that in a minute. I'm truly proud of all of these accomplishments that we have achieved at NDSS. And I know each milestone will be a lasting legacy on our community. But as you know, success is simple, not easy. We have so much more work to do. Last week, the April unemployment numbers were released. 3.9%. That is the lowest in almost two decades. So let me paint a picture for you. The unemployment rate for people with disabilities is approximately 10.5%. That's almost three times that of somebody who doesn't have a disability. The poverty rate for working adults with disabilities is 28.4% compared to 12.4% in the general population. And I would argue that personally, these statistics are even more gloom for individuals with intellectual disabilities. And today, in 2018, equal pay for equal work for workers who have disabilities doesn't exist. Our folks are categorically restricted from earning equal pay under antiquated federal laws, federal labor laws, and physically barred from having full-time jobs. This is something we at NDSS are committed to change once and for all.
Amen.
This is something that will live past me and every single one of you in this room. And this is called Law Syndrome. Down syndrome doesn't define or stop our individuals with Down syndrome. Look around this room. It's these archaic, outdated laws that do. And one of the most archaic discriminatory laws in place is the practice of subminimum wage. A provision in the 1938 Fair Labor Standards Act, yes, I don't think there's anything fair about it, allows employers certified by the Department of Labor to compensate people with disabilities for their work at a far less rate than those that are supposed to be paid the minimum wage. Right now, we at NDSS are actively trying to pass the Time Act, which would reverse this 1938 80-year-old law that discriminates against people with Down syndrome and their wages. Legacy is not something for people. It's leaving something in people. And tonight, as we celebrate our champions, those people with disabilities that are making their mark, Alyssa, Marquez, Ayana, Caroline, Herbert, and Jabari, you, my friends, are living your legacy each and every day. The legacy in each of you, your story, and your accomplishments are helping national and local organizations move mountains. At NDSS, over 25% of our employees have Down syndrome. Churchill once said, and as everyone knows, I'm a huge fan of Churchill, never, never, never give up. If there is one legacy in me that our self-advocates, the individuals that we're celebrating here this evening, have helped shaped, it's one of hard work, passion, and tenacity. Our self-advocates work harder than every one of us in this room each and every day. Not just as individuals, but they're advocates. And they never, never, never give up. Just yesterday, we were on Capitol Hill. You may have seen on social media, or you may be ordering your socks from John's Crazy Socks. Yesterday, John Cronin, a 22-year-old man from Long Island, New York, testified before the U.S. Small Business Committee. John and his dad created John's Crazy Socks a year and a half ago yesterday. John, a tenacious, inspiring, passionate individual, testified before this committee about the success of his business as an entrepreneur. John told members of the U.S. Congress, including yesterday, we rounded the afternoon by meeting with leader Nancy Pelosi, that it's time for time. It's time for these obsolete 1930s, 1960s laws to ride into the sunset. John's business is poised to earn $3.8 million in 2 years. And just 2 days ago, they shipped out their 100,000th order of Crazy Socks. John is living proof through socks and spreading happiness that his story matters. He matters, and people with Down syndrome deserve to be put on an equal playing field. I'm grateful to Casey for opening my eyes to this incredible community, for allowing me to be an advocate alongside my colleagues like Candy, alongside affiliates like the Lowcountry Down Syndrome Society, and most importantly, self-advocates across the country. I will leave you with this. There's no left and there's no right in the disability community. There's only forward. And tonight, tomorrow, next week, next year, for the 10th annual Night of Champions, we go forward. We go forward together, thanks in large part to the leadership of the Lowcountry Down Syndrome Society for bringing us here tonight as advocates. Here, we're focused on putting people with Down syndrome first in your wonderful community, in their schools, in this community, and in their careers. It takes a village, and ESS is grateful to LDSS for your partnership and your advocacy. And last quote, I promise, I often say, if you're not at the table, you're on the menu. At NDSS, our legacy will be the organization that puts people with Down syndrome at every table. At every table where key decisions are made so future generations aren't confined to a life of discrimination, and every individual with Down syndrome is entitled to the same rights as every other American. Together, our path to creating a lasting legacy is simple: human rights. The path to getting there is just not easy. And that's why we need everyone in this room to help NDSS, to help the Lowcountry Down Syndrome Society, and all people with Down syndrome move forward. Thank you.
Sarah Artwiner, President and CEO of the National Down Syndrome Society. And now I get to announce the President's Award. Ty Donaldson of Maven Makers has created a creative community and a platform for others to change the world. But I don't think that he anticipated the impact that he might have on local high school students when he developed a program to help teach them trade skills. And when he was approached with students with different abilities, he had no incentive or background to know that he shouldn't, or to give him any hesitation about accepting them. And so it's because of that willingness, maybe ignorance, I probably shouldn't have gone there, but I did. So, but it's that willingness and also this program that, you know, gets the students to work in those jobs that we are going to achieve. That Ty Donaldson, come on up. Is this year's President's Award winner?
Ty Donaldson, co-founder of Maven Makers. Savannah's a makerspace. I'm honored to be here tonight. Honored to be here tonight to accept this award on behalf of the company. I would like to begin my brief remarks by saying thanks to several individuals who have been impactful. Obviously, first, thanks to Tom. Thank you for seeing the reality of what Maven Makers is, the potential of what it can be, and how that potential can make a lasting impact on people with different abilities. Thank you for choosing Maven Makers to receive this honor and award. Jim Atkinson and David Thomas of Progressive Ability Support Services. But thank you for seeing the potential in the students we are able to serve as we support the students of the Savannah-Chatham County Public School System with the program that we have, and for being a catalyst to jumpstart the program that will be kicking off this year. Bridging the gap from skilled labor training to finding these students sustaining jobs. Also, I thank Jay Thompson with yourself. Thank you for believing in their growing capacity for the current program we support. Your belief has gone beyond the weight of your original concept of your business, the original scope of your nonprofit, and your willingness to create a craftsman sector within the organization to provide at-risk youth a chance to not only be mentored, but also trade skills that can be built on the platform, which is Maven Makers. To Louie Motley, Doug Hancock, Lo Bright, and Dr. Levette, thank you for taking risks and putting your students in a place like Maven Makers, where presumed competence can become a trained competence. To Megan Hodge, Senator Kelnick, and Ben Madden, without whose efforts that we stand on, none of this would be possible. That what we are doing and seeking to do for people of all ages with different abilities. As I believe part of what has brought Maven Makers to this stage, I must also not neglect to thank first, Tim Cullen, my business partner. As a crucial part of this business's existence, its growth and its presence in the capacity in which it serves this community, you have been my partner in business and a wise person. Behind every great man is a great man. And lastly, I thank God, the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, as every good gift is given from above. So, finally, to the speech part. There are three things I want to bring before you tonight. Three things I want to leave with you, unless you use them as you choose. These three things are blessing, presumed competence, and legacy. I'm speaking to you, champions, who have walked up the stage in years past and will walk up tonight and receive an award on the stage. I'm speaking to you, caregivers and supporters, who have stood by and aided these champions. I'm speaking to you who are listening on with seemingly no connection to a champion at all. With these three quick things, blessing, presumed competence, and legacy, I hope to show that we all have a role to play. Shortly, I promise. When I was unknowingly being interviewed for this award by Tom, he asked me how it was we started the program. Blessing of a presumed competence. pursue confidence can be said in another way as faith. Ephesians says about faith, and this is not your own doing, it is a gift of God, so that no man may boast. It's not a result of works, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. So, how many people in this room hold the driver's license to a car? By the large majority of people here.
What?
How many of you, before ever receiving your license, were given the key to your car with the promise that your mom or dad or grandmother or some other responsible party would sit on the other side of the car and teach you how to drive? Tell you how to turn, tell you how hard to brake. I imagine most of you, if you raise your hand, drove yourself here tonight without that person next to you. Why was that? You have a trained competence. Why is that? Because your parents presumed competence in you and had a confidence that you would be able to drive your car with the ease that you do now. As most of us have learned the hard way, trained competence does not always come without its fender benders. This is the way we at Maple Makers have chosen to approach a program that is slated to start in the fall of this year, where we'll be training the people with different abilities as well as those who are considered at risk, giving skilled job training and producing tiny homes for homeless vets, thanks to the efforts of the Chatham-Savannah Authority for the Homeless. We are in the process of developing a curriculum and finding the workers that will be the ones that will stand in the gap for these individuals. They'll be the ones willing to be those who presume competence of all who are going through the training, and to be that parent in the passenger seat that they never had. And to hand the tools and confidence, I believe in you. When Tom asked how this program got started, I told him the answer was not what we had done, but what we had been given. So, what have we been given? We've been given the blessing and opportunity to stand with those with different abilities. Because of those who have gone before us and passed on this opportunity to us. All of us here have been given an opportunity because of those who have gone before us on our behalf, so that we might have the strength and knowledge to be able to stand on our own. How you choose to pass on what you've been given, the blessing of presumed competency, is up to you. This is your legacy. Think about those who have taught you, mentored you, supported you, and entrusted the ability you now possess. What a blessing you have been given that they extended their legacy of the trained competence and presumed upon you the competence that you now call your own. All those who have been and will receive rewards tonight, myself on Maple Makers' behalf included, have received them because of the legacy of presumed competence being given to us and trained competence being that fruit. So may we all hold this legacy that we have been given with a little more gentleness and care, that we may all walk by faith and not by sight, and hold fast this truth, this legacy. So go on and train someone up in the way they should go, so that they too may pass on their legacy to someone else. Let's make something together. Thank you.
Thanks, brother.
Yeah, I love Dr. Ben too, but one of these is mine, Jamie. Keep living it.
I think it's just speaking to the middle. If y'all have a hard time hearing in the back, that's the word that we got. We got to project.
I just thought you were just like being a celebrity car
mommy
or something.
Not even close. If y'all will direct your attention to the video screens, we're going to introduce the 2018 introductory videos of our champions. Woo!
Serving a customer, we'll be joking around a little bit more. The customers kind of see that.
even they, you know, kind of, you can see a smile brighten up in their face and their stressful weeks and stuff like that. So it's definitely great for all of us, customers, employees, everyone, even truck drivers who come through and see him and love him too. So, I mean, he's just...
As we get ready to I do. We have different skills, we have different backgrounds, we have different desires and passions. So you get to meet a group of champions tonight that have excelled in their field. This is not a random selection, this is a merit-based award that is the outcome of being nominated by your coworkers, your employers, or your peers. So it's a pretty stiff competition, and the nominating committee as well as the selection committee has their work cut out for them in this endeavor. So are y'all tired of listening to me talk, and would you like to be a champion?
Are Ms. Daphne and Mr. Hahn. I know God is the best. And I get to tell everyone, have a great weekend.
Places, and she's very
opportunity and honor. And I'm very blessed to have been nominated as a champion. And I promise to do my best at my job and in my life. Thank you very much.
Fearful that I could not properly articulate what she means to us. In short, she changes lives. Her attitude on all things. Thank you. Can I stop? I mean, her attitude on all things, big or small, is absolutely infectious. She changes perspectives on all whom she meets. You know, with the contentiousness and divisiveness that's kind of prevalent today, it's easy to kind of fall into that, to maybe feel stressed out all the time. But you spend 5 minutes with Caroline and you realize what's important in life. Friends, family, truly serving others. She lives by these qualities each and every day, and it comes so naturally to her. It just flows out of her. And as you can see, she's always smiling.
I do.
I'm just walking by her, no matter what's going on at work, no matter how good or bad your day has been, you walk by her. And your whole mood changes. Your whole day just seems to get better. And you can't help but smile too. Right on cue, just like we practice. In fact, I challenge each and every one of you in the room tonight to please take that 5 minutes with her, or at least have her in your vicinity for a couple minutes. And if you don't have the biggest, most genuine smile you've had in a long time, or at least feel enlightened in some way from just having met her, then we need to schedule some interventions, like immediately or something. My business partner spoke earlier. Hollis and I love her. Our staff loves her.
All the time.
Our customers adore her. In fact, when she's not working, I mean, dozens and dozens of customers throughout the day will, you can see they come in, they're looking for her. And they're asking where she is. They're just so excited just to see her again. She makes all of us better individuals.
I do.
And there are very few things on par with that level of impact. I am truly humbled and honored that Caroline and her family have allowed me to share this moment with them tonight. Thank you. That one simple job.
Yank it.
Thank you.
Herbie Hudson. I'm so loud, I may not even need this mic. I look forward to every day with Herbie. Every day, Herbie rings the bell, and he's coming in the back bakery door. We call him our love bug. He is our shining star. Herbie always brings a positive attitude every single day. Herbie has worked for us for 2 years as of next Thursday, and we're having a big party, and y'all are all invited. He's a team player and has learned so much about how the bakery operates and helps everyone in some way. Some way or another, just by being our awesome kitchen assistant. We all love Herbie. We all love Herbie, right? The bakery is a proud partner with Employability. A special thank you to Miss Wanda, Herbie's job coach, who introduced us to Herbie and placed him just perfectly. I would like to encourage other employers to take a chance on folks with different abilities. It's the best decision. It's the best business decision we've ever made. Congratulations, Herbie.
Please, everyone, I want to thank Ms. Wanda first for letting me have the job. I wanted the job ever since I was little. I wanted to do something like that. I was watching on TV. I'm just glad that I was picked.
Want
to
talk about what you do at the bakery?
I wash dishes there.
What's your job title?
Kitchen assistant.
Shaking your head going, wait, what?
Yeah, they want to come to work every day. They want to be on time. They want to do stuff to get paid versus not doing stuff and still getting paid. And I'm not poking fun at the young generation. I created, you know, two of them out there in the workforce. I'm sorry. However, this is an untapped resource in our community. And that's what this night is about, is to get that message out. So, we have another champion queued up and ready to go. So at this time, I'm going to ask Chef Emmanuel May to come up and introduce us to Marquez Smith from Bon Appetit Bike Cafe. called your boss, supervisor, manager to come up here and talk about you from this podium? Would they get choked up? Would the words be as glowing? Would you be singled out as the one person who has the greatest impact on your place of work? I would, right, Blue? See, when you work with your husband, he has to say, oh yeah, you're like our number one draft pick. That's something to think about. That's what I'm talking about at this caliber of employee, that's what you get. You get the game changers, the number one draft picks. All right, so our next champion is, you saw in the video. So if you would help me welcome Carson Fortner to introduce Jabari Tukes with Pooler Karate.
You guys have to give me a minute. Three people didn't show up to one of our tables and there was three pieces of cake left over. So I'm sort of struggling to talk right now. Tell everybody hey.
Hey.
Yeah. My name's Carson Fortner. I'd like to start by congratulating the 2018 champions. Everybody give them a hand. Five years ago, I looked up at this very stage, wiped my eyes from the gallons of tears I just cried, and I said, I want to be a part of that one day. And today, I stand up here with this amazing young man, Jabari Dukes. Jabari is a true example that hard work and perseverance always pays off. When Cindy Burns first told me that she had found the perfect guy for me, I was extremely excited. I interviewed Jabari with his mentor and knew immediately that he was what we needed at Pooler Karate. During his interview, all I could do was talk about the amazing ladies he had been interning with. Right?
Yeah.
I knew I wanted to be part of what he had been experiencing. About one week, I got to see the true Jabari. He's a truly amazing young man who is always smiling and gives me about 100 hugs a day. You guys saw in the video, he hugs me so hard that he tries to pick me up off the ground. He is one of the most selfless and caring people I have met in my life. Every day when I come to work, he gives me a big hug, asks me about my daughter, my wife, and my dog. Then he asks if I'm okay, and then he asks every other employee, are you okay? So. He loves to talk about, he likes to talk to the girls, tell them their hair looks good, right? Miss Stacy, he talks about her hair all the time. And then he says, he talks about basketball. Who's your favorite basketball player?
LeBron James.
So I'll tell you guys a story. One day, Jabari walked into my office. I was talking to my beautiful wife. She's back there on table 17. She's going to be mad at me. Probably blushing right now. But he walked in and I said, Jabari, 1 minute, I'm on the phone, okay? And little did I know how much of an influence that would have on his life. So now he walks around to everybody comes to the door and he says, 1 minute. 1 minute. And he puts his finger up. Jabari, what do you do?
You don't know me.
Just like that. That's right. That's the awesome thing about Jabari. When you get to know him and talk to him, you don't just make a new friend, you become part of his life. All right, anything you say could influence him in a huge way. Jabari comes in every day, cleans the windows, waters the plants, and performs day-to-day operations. One of the biggest jobs he has is he opens up the door to all our customers. And what do you say to our customers? Can you tell them? Welcome.
Welcome to Pooler Karate.
Welcome to Pooler Karate, that's right. In 2014, I met a young man named Austin Smith and his family. They invited me to this event for the very first time. Their son, Austin, inspired me to restart my martial arts program called Special Kicks for Special Needs Individuals.
We now have over 60 students with special abilities ranging from ages 2 and up. The biggest role... The biggest role that Jabari has played in my business is showing other special needs families that their child has a chance to grow up, get a job, and to become involved with their community. Just last week, I had a parent tell me Jabari is doing such a good job and that he encouraged her to start family planning for her son and her daughter who have autism. She said that she wanted her kids to have the same opportunities as Jabari and to be one day self-sustaining. Wow, it sounds to me like Jabari is a superhero for some of these families. One of the best experiences I've had up to this point is the change that he has brought to my other employees. I see them smiling a lot more, and I see their work ethics improving now that Jabari is on board. I asked one employee, Stacy, she's here today with us, how her work experience would have been with Jabari. She said that working with Jabari has been a blessing. Every day as he walks through the doors, he has the biggest smile on his face. He really doesn't walk, he sort of like runs in, he's ready to go. He has the biggest smile on his face, greeting everyone with hugs and always making sure that everyone is having a good day. His smile makes the whole room light up from time to time, from the time he walks in to the time he leaves. His smile is always there. Jabari inspires us appreciate everything so much more. His hard work and determination keeps us motivated here at Pool of Karate. Jabari has also directly influenced me. He has opened my eyes to the future of my business. This year we'll open a new facility, and yes, I already have my eyes on another student with special abilities. The ability to make others smile, the ability to bring out the best in others, and the ability to love others as Christ loves us. In conclusion, I hope you can see that these champions are extremely valuable to this community and the people in it. I hope that they have inspired you to hire individuals with special abilities. Give it up for Jabari Dukes.
Hospital systems, public library system, school system, Restaurants, patient care, specialty clinics, whatever, manufacturing, whatever you have a heart for, whatever your business model is, we can guarantee you there's a champion out there that is like-minded and skilled in that department. So if you have any questions about whether your business model can be replicated with these kinds of successes, there's several professionals in this room tonight who would love to give you a call and explain to you how that can work. But enough about go out and hire a differently abled team member that I'm gonna work into the conversation seven more times. Let's get to our final champion for the evening. This champion's video piece and bio hit me because not only was she an integral part of the team right off the bat, but she created pathways for several other employees to be hired based on her success. So please help me in welcoming Bill and Mark Granger to introduce us to Ayanna Weathers at Granger Honda. Woo!
Associated with people that have ability like you do. I personally want you to know that my life, because of you, will always be better. And I thank you for that. Thank you for being on the Granger team. And we look forward to a long, long relationship. May you always be blessed. And may you always be blessed by God. Congratulations, my friend. You're a well-deserved champion. I see him every day. If you knew him like I know him, you would be impressed as well. I am so glad to be standing here tonight with Mark and to call him my partner and to be working beside him in this event. And this event has touched me tonight. I'd like all of you to know that. Thank you.
That's been a tough act to follow my entire life. And tonight is not going to be any different, I promise you. On behalf of our Granger companies, Bill Granger, our CEO, Granger Honda and Granger Nissan, I want to thank the Low Country Down Syndrome Society for this wonderful event. This is our first year being involved, but I assure you, it won't be our last. Last July, we were looking for someone in our Honda store to do some scanning and filing. We had car deals and service repair orders that were just piling up and had accumulated over time. There were stacks of boxes that seemed to be everywhere in the accounting office. It's quite a monotonous job for someone to do all day long, every day. We had tried a number of different things to get caught up, but nothing seemed to work. We had hired students after school. We had tried to pay overtime and get people to stay at night, but nothing seemed to work. That's when Brandon, our HR manager, told us about employability. At the time, I'm sorry to say, I had never heard of employability. He suggested that we consider hiring someone with a disability to do this job and explain why that may be a good fit for what we're looking to get done. I have to admit that we were quite reluctant at first. After talking with the representative from Employability, she recommended two people for us to interview. At the time, our initial thoughts were that we would hire one person to work 6 hours a day. That would have been a mistake because we would never have finished the job. After the interviews, we decided to hire both of them. We made it a full day's work, and both of them worked 5 hours a day. Ayanna Weathers, who is beside me and being honored tonight as a champion, was our very first hire, along with Nathan Shambley, who is here tonight also. Nathan, if you would please stand. As I said, we were looking to hire one, but we got a pair, and I'm here to tell you, the two of them together have done a fantastic job at what we wanted to get done. I only wish that we could honor him as well tonight, but he does a great job.
They've both done a great job for us. They did such a great job with us at Honda that Spencer Thomas, the executive manager and our partner at Granger Nissan, hired two workers through employability to do the same job. Between both of our companies, we have hired a total of 7 people through employability in the past year. What we've learned is that working with people with different abilities is no different than working with any other employee. You have to interview them, make sure they're the right person for the job. You have to train and continue to coach them. One of the beautiful things through the employability program is that they provide a job coach to train and work along with your new employee until they're ready to work on their own. These employees want to know what they're doing. They want to know that they're doing a good job. Just like any other employee like to be rewarded when they do. They don't want to be treated any different than the other employees. They just want to fit in and be part of the family. And that's exactly how Bill and I see them. Spencer, Rustin, we all see them just that way. All of our employees. Speaking of family, let me tell you about one of the 7 that we hired, Mr. Harold Hazel. He was the 3rd person we hired through employability. We hired him to help keep our shop and break room clean throughout the day. It's never looked so spotless as when Harold was on the job. He was a hardworking and a sweet man. He's a hardworking man and a sweet man. One day he told Kristen, his job coach, just after he got his uniforms, that, quote, "You know, Miss Kristen, I really do feel like I'm part of the Granger family. It's just like that commercial says, you're never a stranger at Granger." He was so proud. Harold loved going to the movies on the weekends. Some of our technicians got together and actually bought him movie passes. They checked with Miss Kristen to make sure that was okay to give them to him. He was looking forward to coming to our Christmas party. We have a huge Christmas party. It's grown very, very large. But sadly, Harold passed away in early December. Even though Harold was only with us for a short while, he touched many lives in such a big way. We all miss Harold. For those of you that are employing people with disabilities, I commend you. I'm sure that you see the benefits every day in attitudes and morale within your company. We've heard that from everyone standing on this podium before me. For those of you that are hesitant, I challenge you, just do it. I promise you, you'll be glad you did. The experience for you, your employees, as well as your customers will be a positive one. Now let's talk about Ayana, our champion. Since birth, Ayana has had to overcome obstacles in her pathway, but she's never let her disabilities define her. She has many traits that make her successful and the person that she is today. First of all, she's extremely dependable. That's one thing I've heard about everyone up here tonight, and I believe that to be true of all 7 of the employees we hired in the past year. She always, and I mean always, arrives early and has her lunch before clocking in. I wish all of our employees did that. She listens to her music, sometimes does crossword puzzles, and reads whatever book she is on at the time before her work day begins. I think one of the last ones had to do was Tyler Perry, something, one of the Tyler Perry books. Don't talk about it. Sorry, I think I busted her out. I don't think she's, you know, I don't think she's there. I know she's never missed a day of work. She is a cheerful person. I've never seen her have a bad day.
If she does, I don't know that any of us would know it, because you never see her without a smile on her face. That's one of the first things that you notice about Ayana, is her smile. And I don't care if it's the beginning of her shift or the end of the day, she's always happy. Another thing that she is as Bill said earlier, she is talented and she does have a beautiful voice, I promise you that. If I asked her, she would probably sing tonight, but we only have 10 minutes. Another thing is that she's loyal to her friends, family, and co-workers. Her table is full of her family tonight, and thank you all for allowing us to be a part of this event. You'll notice at our table that many of her co-workers in her department, she's in the accounting department, are here tonight. If y'all would stand. All of you that are, not everyone, but everyone in our accounting department is here for IOM tonight. And that's because she wanted them all to be here, and not a single one declined. Everyone in our accounting department is here tonight in our honest room. I have the distinct honor and pleasure to introduce to you my friend, our Granger Honda 2018 champion, Ayana Weathers.
Hello.
Hello.
I would first like to thank the Low Country Down Central Society for picking me as a champ. Night of Champions, it is such an honor to be selected as a champion. It really means a lot to me. Thank you to everyone that has come out tonight to show their love and support for me. It is such a blessing to be a part of the Granger team and be supported by all my co-workers. I wanted to thank Mr. Bill Granger and Mr. Mark Granger for giving me the opportunity to work in such a positive, uplifting, and supportive environment. I enjoy what I do. I really love all the scanning and filing so much. I would like to also thank my job coach, Kristen Wigan, for helping me to find my job and for helping me learn all the duties and making sure I was comfortable with my job. This job means so much to me. This job has made me work hard and step out of my comfort zone at times. But it has been worth it because I love what I do. And I love working with all my coworkers at Granger Honda. I really feel like part of the Granger family. I want to thank my supervisors and co-workers for always being there to help me figure things out and encourage me to do my best. I would also like to thank my former supervisor and friend, Sylvia, for coming out tonight and supporting me since my first job at Chatham County Human Research. Finally, I would like to thank my mom and my brother John for always being there for me. And my dad, he's not here, couldn't make it, for being my best friend and my number one encourager. And thank you, and God bless you all. Good times, and in bad times, I'll be on
And now Jamie will sing for us too.
What's that? I missed that.
I told them you were going to sing, Jamie.
Next year. I'll have to get tickets early. It's going to be a big show next year.
Wow. Well, we've heard some pretty amazing stories tonight. I want to recognize one more group of people, though. We would be remiss talking about legacy. Would all of the parents or support people in the lives of the champions please stand up and let us recognize you, because you started this legacy by believing, encouraging, and helping these champions become who they are today. Started a long time ago for them. They created this legacy of ability, and they're the ones that have helped these champions reach where they are. But the good news is, you did not have to physically give birth to one of these champions to be a part of the story of legacy. See where I'm going with this?
Thank goodness.
So, as Jamie and I get prepared to make our closing remarks, I would like to invite the champions to come back on stage with your awards. Champions, come on back up here.
Y'all, I'm amazed. I've seen this grow every year. Every year. To see Mr. Granger come up and say he'd never been here before, to think how this spreads, this is truly spreading every year. It never fails to fill my heart, and it lasts for a year, and then I have to come back. Is everybody full this year? Can you believe?
Yeah.
It's so easy to find challenges in your lives, but this is real. This is love and support, and as I've had the blessing to work with a previous champion, and the effects that it can have on your business, and I just encourage you to try it for your business. It will change your life as it changed our family's lives. And I'm super happy to be here. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of a night that means so much to my family and I.
Woo!
So as you look into the faces of these champions and know the caliber of people they are, the impact that they have made on the businesses that they are a part of, I'm asking you, what is your legacy?
Yeah.
Whose life will you change? Good night, everybody.
Woo!